Rejoice in the Lord, you righteous ones. Praise from the upright is fitting.
May your mercy, O Lord, be upon us. May your mercy be upon us, who have placed our hope in you.
Wisdom.
A reading from St. Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brothers and sisters, as I see it, God has put us apostles at the end of the line, like men doomed to die in the arena. We have become a spectacle to the universe, to the angels and men alike. We are fools on Christ's account. Ah, but in Christ you are wise. We are the weak ones, you are the strong ones. They honor you while they sneer at us. Up to the very hour we go hungry, thirsty, poorly clad, roughly treated, wandering around homelessly. We work hard at the manual labor. When we are insulted, we respond with a blessing. Persecution comes our way. We bear it patiently. We are slandered, and we are tried conciliation. We have become the world's refuge. The scum of the earth, that is the present state of the affairs. I am writing you in the way not to shame you, but to admonish you as my beloved children. Granted, you have 10,000 guardians in Christ. You only have one Father. It is why I begot you, Christ Jesus, through my preachings of the gospel. I beg you then to be the imitators of me.
Peace be to your ear.
Wisdom be attentive.
God grants me vindication and subdues his people under me. Has given great victories to the king and has shown love for David, his anointed, his descendants forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
May God, through the prayers of the holy, glorious, and illustrious Apostle and Evangelist Matthew, grant that you proclaim the word with great power for the fulfillment of the gospel of his beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Wisdom, understand, and listen to the holy gospel.
Peace be to all.
Man is going to be delivered into the hands of men that will put him to death,
and he will be raised up on the third day.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
In the gospel you just heard, Jesus said, I say to you, if you have faith like a grain of mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. You know, this is a favorite verse for people who are longing to have a Ferrari or a Lamborghini or a really nice house at the shore on LBI. Oh, what a promise from the Bible that God will move mountains in my life. That God will grant me what is impossible by my own strength. Wow, what a verse. This is a very dangerous piece of text if you misinterpret it and misapply it based on selfish reasons and lusts. I don't really think that's what Jesus is teaching us at all. Jesus is not saying that our God is a genie in a bottle and you rub it and it'll do our bidding. Not at all, because the Bible, actually St. James is very clear. You ask, and you do not receive because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. God is not a servant who will do our selfish biddings. He is the great God whom we serve. So when we pray, when we ask, when we believe, it's not that God will do what I want. It's believing that God will do what is his will. I want to remind you that we can also swing to the other extreme. Instead of saying God will do what we want, we may swing to the other extreme and actually say God cannot do what we ask him. That's also equally wrong. I think the biblical understanding is God can and will move mountains when we have faith in him, when we seek him in his will. So today, some of us are facing mountains in life. I think this is a very encouraging message. Maybe we're struggling with stress or anxiety, and I realize that there are more and more people in these current times facing these mountains. They can't move forward in life because they're crippled. They're paralyzed with fears and anxieties and panics, with depression. I realize there are many people today who are struggling with addiction. You know, our society today, here in America, our society is the most dependent society since the beginning of time. Alcohol, medications, illicit drugs, and it goes on and on and on. There are so many people today who are trapped in bitterness and unforgiveness. They somehow know that it's right to forgive, but they can't seem to find the grace to forgive. There's a huge mountain in their spiritual life, and it's killing them. They are stagnating in their walk. And this is where we need to say, God, you need to help me move these mountains. And in today's gospel, the apostles may recognize and believe that Jesus is the Christ, but they don't have faith that Jesus will deliver them. They had no faith in that given situation. This is the second time that this phrase is used in the Gospel of Matthew. What just happened last week? Peter was sinking. He was walking on the water. And then he looked at all the winds and the waves, and he was terrified, and he began to sink. And Jesus said, oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt? Why did you stop believing? Why did you not believe in this given situation? And you know, there's actually a third time in Matthew. when he says, "Oh, you of little faith, why are you still talking about bread, worrying that there is no bread, and not believing in me?" So the reasons why the disciples could not cast out the demon was because, according to Jesus' own words, they had little faith, probably referring to how they had faith that Jesus is in fact Christ, but not having faith that Jesus and his authority was enough. They had no faith in that given situation. Therefore, Jesus said, "If you have faith the grain of a mustard seed," So no faith, and actually all the faith you need is a small faith, like a grain of a mustard seed. And Jesus is saying to his disciples, the reason why you could not cast out the demon is because you have no faith in me. Because if you only had faith the size of a mustard seed, you would say to this mountain, "Move from here to there," and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. I think this is a fascinating concept. We often think that when there's a great mountain, you need to have great faith. And that's a big problem, a difficult problem. So I need to have big faith. You know what Jesus is saying? You don't need big faith. The mustard seed is all you need. You know what Jesus is saying? You need a mustard seed. It's not great faith only that moves mountains. Mustard seed faith can also move mountains. And so Jesus is giving us a concept that, if we think most of us wouldn't realize, he's saying all you need is not big faith, giant faith, huge faith, but see God with that small mustard seed of faith. The focus of the Christian is not how great is my faith. The focus of a Christian is how great is our God. And I need to believe in him. So I've got a key statement for you. Because impossibilities become realities. For mountains to move, for something impossible, something real, for impossibilities to become realities, it doesn't take much faith. It only takes faith. You see, I think this is practical because many of us feel that the mountains in our lives, the stress, the worries, the sins, the unforgiveness, the bitterness, the roadblocks, we see these mountains in our lives, and we're so paralyzed because we feel that our faith is not enough. When we say have faith in God, it's not psychology. It's not just thinking. It's not just considering. It's saying, "Lord, help me." It's a casting our dependence on God in a place of prayer. Christian living is not just making choices. Oh, please don't get me wrong. Christian living involves making many biblical choices. But what I am saying is, Christian living is not just making choices, because not only must we be able to obey, we must pray to obey. Because the power to obey does not come from us. The power to change, the power to move mountains, comes from God. So faith, my friends, is best expressed in prayer. You see, the disciples didn't get what they wanted. They didn't manage to cast out the demons. They might have tried in many different ways. They might have said a lot of words. I suppose that the disciples must have been casting out demons over quite a bit of time by now. And maybe they just got complacent. They must have thought to themselves, "I could do this. It's easy. We've got it under control." And so they've left off the place of dependence. They left off prayer. And how often is it true in our lives when we begin struggling with anything, we become very prayerful? We were saying, "Lord, unless you help me, there's no way I can fix this. My family situation is terrible. You need to help us. And so we're very dependent. We're very humble. We were praying. And after a while, when God gives you some measure of success, somehow we thought, oh, I did it. And we slip off prayer, and now sin comes back in and takes a grip on our life once again. Your problems seem to overwhelm you once again, and so you come to God and say, why am I still defeated in sin? Because of your little faith. Because this kind does not go out but by prayer. You stop praying. You stop looking at me. So when you have a worry, it is a mountain. When you have stress, it is a mountain. When you have unsaved loved ones, it is a mountain. And when you've broken home relationships, it's a mountain. Don't think these problems away. Don't say to yourself, I'm going to think rightly and that I won't worry. I'm going to guard my thoughts so that I will not fear. God can move mountains, but prayer and faith can move God. When we talk about mountains moving faith, people would think about big faith. My dear brothers and sisters, I pray that God will move mountains in your life as you exercise your faith in prayer. When someone cuts you off when you're driving, pray. You deal with the problem ASAP. Who knows what ASAP means? Who knows what ASAP means? As soon as possible. Wrong. Never listen to the sermon. You must deal with the problem always with ASAP. Always say a prayer. And how you deal with it, because if you resort on your own strength, you're not going to make it. You're going to fail. You're still going to be angry. You're still going to be vicious. And you're still going to be vengeful. You need God to move that mountain. You know what's the greatest fear in my mind? Exactly what happened in this passage. We cast out demons. Not. The church is doing well. Not. And we have all the reason to say, we've got it under control. And then one day, we realize, how come we're dying? How come there's no life change? How come we're struggling in our church life? How come there's so many infections and divisions? Why? 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 Because God's people have forgotten how to pray. We're too capable. We're too resourceful to pray. I know you all pray at home. I hope. Let me tell you that prayer time is when God really moves in a great way. Would you walk by faith? Would you live by faith? Don't hide behind excuses today, because any faith will do. Remember, it doesn't take much faith for the impossibilities of your life to become realities. It only takes faith the size of a mustard seed. Glory to Jesus Christ. Slava Jesus Christ. Let us all say with our whole soul, our whole mind, and
Lord, have mercy.
For you are merciful and loving God, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. His kingdom, our Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, our most reverend Metropolitan William, our God-loving Bishop Curry, the entire priestly, diaconal, monastic order, our government, and all the service of our country, and the ever-memorable founders and benefactors of this holy church. May the Lord God remember all you Christians of the true faith, always, now, and ever, and forever. That our sacrifice may be pleasing to you, and that the good spirit of your grace may rest on us, on these gifts here present, and on all your people. Grant us for the mercies of your begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and forever.
The Trinity, one in essence. Thank you.
sacrifice, and we implore, pray, and entreat you, send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these holy gifts lying here before us, and make this bread the precious body of your Christ, and that which is in this chalice the precious blood of your Christ, changing them by your Holy Spirit, that for those who partake of them they may bring about a spirit of vigilance, the remission of sins, the communion of your Holy Spirit, the fullness of the heavenly kingdom, and confidence in you, not judgment or condemnation. Moreover, we offer you the spiritual sacrifice for those departed in faith, the forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and for every just spirit brought to perfection in faith, especially for most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary. Preserve them for your holy churches in peace, honor, and safety and health. For many years have they faithfully impart the word of your truth.
And remember,
O Lord, the city in which we dwell, in every city and community, and the faithful living in them. Remember, O Lord, those who travel by sea and land, the sick, the suffering, the captive, and grant them salvation. Remember, O Lord, those who bring offerings and perform good deeds in your holy churches, and those who remember the poor. And upon all of us, send down your mercies, and grant that with one voice and one heart, we may glorify and praise your most honored and magnificent name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
May the mercies of our great God and Savior be with all of you.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth.
by your immeasurable power you have fashioned all things, and in the greatness of your mercy have brought all things out of non-existence into being. Look down from heaven and master upon us and bow against you. For they did not bow to flesh and blood, but to you, the awesome God. Therefore, O Master, make smooth for the good of all the path that lies ahead, according to the need of each. Sail with those who sail, travel with those who travel, cure those who are sick, of physician of souls and bodies. Grant through the birth, through the grace, the mercies, and loving kindness of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Sing the body of Christ, drink the soul. God, risen from the dead, mercy us and save
6 to the prisoner's most pure mother, and the holy, glorious, and illustrious apostles of our holy father John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of the holy dormition of the Mother of God on this prefestive day, of the holy prophet Micah, whose feast it is, and for the translation of the relics of our venerable father Theodosius, Agamen of the Monastery of the Caves, of the holy apostle Thomas, patron of this church, and through the prayers of all the saints, for Christ is good and loves us all.
Amen.
So we will do the blessing of flowers right now, and then we will, prior to coming up to receive the flowers, you can take the flower, we will pray to the Mother of God as we normally do.
There we go. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God Almighty, eternal, by your word alone, you created out of nothing the heavens, earth, sea, and all things visible and invisible. You commanded that the earth give forth plants and trees for the needs of man and animal, each according to its need. In your infinite goodness, you ordained that these plants serve not only as food for the animal, but also as medicine for the sick body. We beseech you, bless these different plants and fruits and bestow upon them your blessing, and endow them with your power so that they may serve man and animal alike as a defense against all sickness and all that is impure. For you are our God, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
These flowers are blessed and sanctified by the sprinkling of this holy water, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Blessed be the name of our Lord, now and forever.
George, and to all the people here, many blessed, happy, and healthy years.